Good morning, students. Today we will discuss another problem. Solve the initial value problem IVP. Y double dash plus y dash plus 0.25 y is equal to 0. The initial conditions are y 0 is equal to 3 and y dash 0 is equal to minus 3.5. To solve this equation, first we take y double dash is equal to d square y by dx square plus y dash dy by dx plus 0.25y is equal to 0. Then we take d by dx as d. Then we get d square y plus dy plus 0.25y is equal to 0. This is d square plus d plus 0.25 y is equal to 0. Then we can write the auxiliary equation A. Auxiliary equation A is equal to lambda square plus lambda plus 0.25 y is equal to 0. Lambda square plus lambda plus 0.25 is equal to 0. This is equal to lambda square plus lambda plus 0.25 is equal to 1 by 4 is equal to 0. That is 4 lambda square plus 4 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. Then we solve this equation. 4 lambda square plus 4 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. We can solve this equation. For solving, 4 lambda square plus 4 lambda can be taken as 2 lambda plus 2 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, 4 lambda square plus 2 lambda, from this we can take 2 lambda outside. Therefore, we get 2 lambda plus 1 plus 2 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. Then 2 lambda plus 1 taken outside, 2 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, 2 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0 and 2 lambda plus 1 is equal to 0. From these two equations, we get lambda is equal to minus 1 by 2, lambda is equal to minus 1 by 2. Here, the roots are repeated. Since the roots are repeated, the complementary function y is equal to c1 plus c2x e raised to minus 1 by 2 x. This is case 2. When the roots are repeated, if the roots are repeated, we can write the complementary function as c1 plus c2x into e raised to minus 1 by 2x. This is the second case. If the roots are repeated, roots are minus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2, then we can write the solution complementary function y is equal to c1 plus c2x into e raised to minus 1 by 2x. Next step, we have to find out the value of c1 and c2. To find the value of c1 and c2, we can apply the initial conditions. The initial conditions are y is equal to c1 plus c2x e raised to minus 1 by 2x. The y0 is equal to 3. That implies 3 is equal to, we put x is equal to 0. C1 plus this term will be 0. X is equal to 0. Therefore, this is will be 1. Therefore, the value of C1 is equal to 3. The first constant C1 is equal to 3. To get the second constant C2, take the derivative of the y. Therefore, y dash is equal to, we can apply the product rule for differentiation. C1 plus C2x into e raised to minus 1 by 2x into minus 1 by 2. First function into derivative of seconds. E raised to minus 1 by 2x into derivative. E raised to minus 1 by 2x into minus 1 by 2 plus e raised to minus 1 by 2x into c2. C1 is 0. Therefore, C2x, derivative of C2x is equal to C2. Then we apply the initial conditions y dot 0 is equal to y dot 0 is equal to 3.5 minus y dot 0 is equal to minus 3.5. That implies we put minus 3.5 is equal to here C1 plus x is equal to 0. Therefore, second term will be 0. Therefore, e raised to minus 1 by 2 x, e raised to minus 1 by 2 x, that is equal to 1 into minus 1 by 2 plus here x is equal to 0. Therefore, C2. Therefore, minus 3.5 is equal to C1 divided by minus 2 plus C2. That is minus 3.5 is equal to C1 is equal to 3 and C1 is equal to 3. 3 divided by minus 2 plus C2. Therefore, we get the value of C2 is equal to simplifying minus 3.5 and minus 3 minus 3 by 2. The answer will be minus 2. Minus 2. Therefore, the value of C2 is equal to minus 2. Therefore, the final solution, y is equal to value of C1 is equal to 3 plus C2 is equal to minus 2x e raised to minus 1 by 2. This is the final solution. This is the procedure to find the solution of this differential equation y double dash plus y dash plus 0.25 y is equal to 0, where the initial conditions y 0 is equal to 3 and y dot 0 is equal to minus 3.5. To find the solution, first we find the symbolic form, then write the auxiliary equation. After finding the auxiliary equation, find the roots of lambda. Here the roots of lambda are repeated, minus 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. Therefore, we apply the case 2. Therefore, C1 plus C2x into e raised to minus 1 by 2x. After that, we apply the initial conditions. By applying the initial conditions, we get the first constant C1 is equal to 3 and second constant C1 is equal to minus 2. The final answer will be y is equal to 3 plus minus 2x into e raised to minus 1 by 2x. Okay.